Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Nature's Always Right. I'm Steven, here helping you to grow food naturally at your home or on your farm. Today we're going to be talking about a really important topic when you're setting up your irrigation system, especially if it's for a larger scale or you're trying to extend pressure and you don't know how much you're going to need to make it. So all we're going to need is just one of these simple pressure regulator dials, and this is one that fits onto a hose fitting, so it's really easy. And then you just need something to measure. This is a 4-quart bowl here. 4 quarts is 1 gallon. We'll be measuring the pressure at the same time. We're letting the water flow out. Count how many seconds it takes to fill the 4 quarts. Divide that by 60, and that will give us our gallons per minute at the flow rate, because we'll be measuring it. The best way to measure and build one of these would be to build your own little testing rig. Michael Kilpatrick did this awesome Facebook video that I'm gonna try to find the link for, and I'll put it in the description. It just goes hose, PVC valve, this thing on top, and then a connector to connect into whatever it is that you need to connect to measure. So whether it's a hose or half inch or 1 inch, whatever it may be. So our water main for the house is set up at right about 60 PSI. It's running through the entire house and getting here, but as it's running through the entire house, it is losing flow rate, as with every turn and every fitting it goes through and the link that it goes through, there's friction. So it's slowing down the flow rate. So when we actually run water through this, the pressure's gonna drop. So we'll hit the stopwatch here and we'll fill this up and see how fast it happens. So about 11 seconds. So if we do 60 divided by 11, that's gonna give us our flow rate of 5.5 gallons per minute. Okay, so that's how you figure out the flow rate. And that was the flow rate at 60 PSI. That's the flow rate that we're getting at 60 PSI through the entire system. Let's say we're just running, that was with it fully open, right? If we just run it at half, you could see it now it was bumping down to 40 PSI. What's my flow rate at 40 PSI? So for that one, we got 27. So 60 divided by 27. Now we're at 2.2 gallons per minute. So as we lose pressure, we're losing flow rate. And the further that water goes through the system, the less flow rate that you're gonna have. Where this becomes really useful is now you can test, if you build that system I was describing, you could take this and go test it down at the end of your system. So if you're thinking about, can I open up another 100 by 100 foot plot and just run a little bit more line? So now you can figure that out. Okay, so now what do you do with this information? Well, I recommend using a drip calculator. You can go to dripdepot.com. I'm gonna put a link in the description for their little calculators. Once you have your gallons per minute and your flow rate at that certain pressure rate, now you can figure out a lot more things. You can figure out how much mainline you're gonna need, how much drip tape you're gonna need, all that sort of stuff. So I'll put a link to those calculators if you wanna help yourself be able to figure those different numbers out. If you ever buy anything through Drip Depot, please check out my links in the description.